Hi, I'm Jay.
Hi, I'm Alyssa.
Hello, I'm Ita.
And these are some of our favorite books from the 2023 summer reading lists.
JD has a problem. It's the night before third grade, and his mom has just given him his first haircut. And it's the worst. When he can no longer take the steady stream of insults from everyone at school, he takes matters into his own hands and discovers that unlike his mom, he is a genius with the clippers. He gets so much talk from his fresh new cut that he decides to open his own barbershop from his bedroom. But when Henry Jr., the owner of the only barbershop in town, realizes that he's losing clients to JD, he tries to get him shut down for good. There's only one way to solve this. A barber battle. If JD wins, he can keep cutting hair without interference from Henry. But if Henry wins, JD has to hang up his clippers for good. Can JD prove he has what it takes and win the Great Barber Battle? Find out in JD and the Great Barber Battle by Jay Dillard, the first book in JD, the Kid Barber series.
Are you afraid of the dark? Then this book is not for you. Mr. Shivers presents five stories in this chapter book for young readers. The text is easy to read, and there are full-color illustrations in this first book of a series. At the end of the book, the illustrator has added a page that shows you how to draw one of the toys from the dark and stormy night story. But the question is, what is beneath the bed? How does a hair reach all the way from your throat to your stomach? Why not take the quilt from the statue? What happens to the toys left outside? And what is scratching the window? Each eerie story ends with an unexpected twist. If you like scary stories, then this is the book for you. Do you dare read this book?
JoJo McCoons is a vivacious little girl living on an Ojibwe reservation, and she's having some communication troubles at school. She tries and tries to be more friendly to the other kids, but her hijinks don't always turn out as expected. Her linguistic mix-ups evoke Amelia Bedelia, and her rambunctious attitude reminds me of Junie B. Jones. If you'd like to be JoJo's friend and learn a bit about Ojibwe culture along the way, be sure to check out the JoJo McCoon series by Don Quigley.
Sim loves everything spooky, thanks to his mom's tales of mythical creatures, which he is certain are real. His new town is really starting to freak him out. There are weird noises at night, eerie lights, and now there's an evil tree, which is growing way faster than it should. Clearly, there is something supernatural going on here. Asim's new friends must use their scientific wits and ghost smarts to defeat the tree and save their town. If you are a fan of mysteries, scientific investigations, and a little bit of the supernatural, you should definitely check out The Ghost Tree, the first book in the Spooky Sleuths by Natasha Dean, which is based on ghost stories from Guyana.
Fairy Spell, how two girls convinced the world that fairies are real. Are fairies real? This book begins in 1917 when Frances and Elsie first photographed the fairies. The girls' photographs convince many people, including Arthur Conan Doyle, author of the Sherlock Holmes books. Based on a true story, this book is illustrated with India ink and watercolor illustrations and includes some of the original photographs. It includes an author's note and sources for further investigation. Perhaps you might be convinced, too.
Caterpillar is in danger of being eaten by a hungry chickadee. Luckily, brave knight Sir Ladybug and his trusted herald and squire are on the case. But these bugs are no match for a monstrous bird. Could a world-famous, life-changing lemon layer cake be just the thing to save the day? Sir Ladybug is an adorable and hilarious comic book series by Corey R. Taber, whose work you might recognize from his Fox the Tiger series. I wonder what quest Sir Ladybug will face next.
You can't help but smile as you read through Happy Sloth Day by April Polisaire and Jeff Sayer. Not only is this book full of adorable photographs of sloths, readers will also learn fascinating details about sloth life. Did you know that almost a third of a sloth's body is stomach? Follow sloth's movements over a day and learn what they eat, how they protect themselves from predators, and how they are interconnected to other species. If you enjoy this, you should also check out Being Frog, a similar book which features amazingly detailed photographs of frogs.
We all know animals that hibernate in winter. Bears and chipmunks and groundhogs and snakes. But summertime sleepers? Yes, there are animals that estivate. That is, sleep in the summertime. Each two-page spread details a different animal in various parts of the world. Some sleep in groups, some alone, some sleep all summer, and some doze on days that are too hot or there's too little food available. A black and white sketch shows each animal and gives its size and proper name in English and Latin and tells us why it is sleeping. Here, the leopard gecko in Pakistan sleeps inside a cozy den and gets its energy from food stored in its tail. At the end of the book, there is more information about each animal with notes from the author and the illustrator. An interesting book for scientists and animal lovers.
Calling all future engineers, architects, artists, and historians. Concrete is a material you interact with every day, but how much do you know about it? In Concrete from the Ground Up, Larissa Tooley shows us the history of concrete from one of its earliest known uses over 10,000 years ago, through the time the technology was lost, to some of the innovative and artistic uses today. Steve Light's quirky illustrations bring the history to life with informative and sometimes colorful commentary from the characters on the pages.